Yo, man, I want to shout out Hip Hop Appreciation Week. My name is Q Rock. I represent Ready to Rock. I represent the Mighty Zulu Kings, Universal Zulu Nation.
What up? This is Frost Flow, Ground Illusions Crew, Conscious Souls, representing Unity Charity and Blueprint for Life. This is a shout out for Hip Hop Appreciation Week and Hip Hop Northern.
Yo, this is DJ Unknown from Troopers. Shout out to Hip Hop Northern and Hip Hop Appreciation Week. You know, this is how it's going down. Representing the culture, keeping it real, and educating the people on where this came from.
My name is Q-Rock, or Manitou Neiman. Born from Nipissing First Nations, Native Reservation, Northern Ontario. I'm Ojibwe and Haida. Been in the game for, I would say, 25, 26 plus years.
So my name is Marcelino Joseph da Costa. Marcelino Joseph da Costa. I've been dancing for about 16 years under the moniker Frost Flow. I'm the founder of the Ground Illusions crew. And I'm also into various arts, like visual art, and playing with music here and there, and just an appreciator and a practitioner of all kinds of art forms, specifically through dance. That's my thing as a b-boy.
Like I said, it's DJ Unknown, DJ and producer for Troopas primarily. I've also done a lot of freelance DJing and freelance production, 2020 Project, King Just, Crown of Thorns. I've worked with a lot of Toronto artists on co-production collaborations, etc. Originally, when we started out doing this, I was living in Saga. I grew up in Saga. Moved out of Saga out to the sticks in Milton. But generally speaking, for the hip-hop community, we hold it down for Saga and for Toronto. Troopas, we've been releasing music for over a decade now. Even before I was in Troopas, I've just grown up as a DJ. I was DJing since I was 12 years old, you know. So being around hip-hop for more than 20 years of my life, I'm here and I ain't going nowhere, and this is what it's about. It's about hip hop. It's about the heritage. It's about exactly what you guys are dealing with right now.
Well, I can give you two answers for that. I can give you my personal opinion on what hip hop is to me, and I can give you the actual facts of what real hip hop really is. So the facts are that it's b-boying, MCing, DJing, graffiti, writing, you know what I'm saying, bombing. That's what hip hop is. And it's an art form. It's a platform for you to express yourself.
A perspective and a mentality is somewhat of a school of thought. It allows us to respect our heritage, to create something from nothing, to be creative, to be conscious of our local environment, of our local culture, to be expressive with those things, to be communicative, and to all kind of respect through a tradition that was paved before us since the 1970s, specifically through stuff that was happening in the Bronx in New York. We have influences from all different nations and cultures and different type of choice. So I think what hip makes our culture distinct and our people distinct is the fact that we are inclusive, even though we seem fairly exclusive with what we do. After getting involved in hip-hop, I've become a lot more culturally sensitive to other people and respecting my own culture specifically.
It's distinct because if you follow the recipe, it's a very, it allows you to be yourself more so than any other really outlet of art form expression. It really focuses on the individual and their originality of who they are.
Hip hop to me, it's so cliche, but a lot of people say how it's a way of life. But when you're a kid and something like hip hop comes into your life at a formative age, like 10 or 12, and it grabs a hold of a part of your psyche, and then you just embrace it fully, you can't help but have that become part of you.
I think about pioneers, OGs. I think about elders, you know what I mean?
I think about what's happened in the past and what's carried on through tradition, I think of preservation.
Heritage to me is like, you know, foundation. It's heritage is traditions, cultures, ceremonies.
I think of evolution, you know, mind, body, spirit, choice, environment, ritual. You know, I think of a lot of different things. Identity. Well, definitely. It definitely does. It's rooted through the music. It's rooted through intention behind the music, through having a good time, through partying, through it's catharsis. It's expressive. It's a soul, you know. I think that heritage is really rooted in people relating with each other, sharing with each other, building with each other. That tradition is rooted in the breaks and the rhythm and the sound and the context behind why music is created and you know, where it's been and where it's going. So, you know, I think things like, as I mentioned, sharing and battling and creating things, being fresh, that's all part of it. Hip-hop heritage, becoming knowledgeable, applying wisdom.
Oh, it definitely has heritage, definitely. Very important to never forget where you come from. If you are an active participant in what you are describing yourself as to be involved in is in hip-hop, then you know you have to know about the Universal Zulu Nation. You have to know about the Zulu Kings. You have to know about Afrika Bambaataa. You have to know about all the original contributors to what we now call hip hop as a lifestyle, art form, slash culture. It's a, you know, it's really important. Like, you know, you pay respect to your elders. It's a circle, and there's bridges that are connected, and there's a revolution through the evolution of this culture, because this culture is meant to evolve, constantly adapt. But there's a revolution of everything. And when the two of them are perfect, it forms a sphere. It's like it's really strong, and like it's stronger than just the circle itself. It carries a spirit with it. So it's important to, like, you know, honor those that are before you, so that they finally get the acknowledgement for their contributions to what they have done. And in return, you're gonna get some gems, you know? You're gonna get a lot of wisdom from their experiences. They're gonna pass it on to you.
Yeah, so for me, hearing a voice now that's speaking about stuff that to me was relevant to my community all of a sudden, like, holy shit, yeah, like, you know, shit isn't equal. There's not an equal playing field in everything that I'm part of. That resonated. And then, you know, it progressed, and I started hearing about other bands in hip-hop. And, but you know, for me, the biggest turning point was hearing Chuck D speak and really put knowledge on wax and made me question things that I was taught growing up to be truths, right? Like, Elvis is the king. You don't question that shit. Elvis is the fucking king of rock and roll. And when I went back and questioned, it's like, holy fuck, this dude's not the king of shit. He appropriated a style and a culture and then flipped it and made money off of it and didn't, you know, and the people who built that foundation don't even know who the fuck they are. So for me, to have those doors and that kind of knowledge opened up at 13, man, I just dove headlong into it, and then it just went from there.
Yeah, the battle, for sure. Definitely the battle. And how battle is relevant is, the battle is a debate, it's communication, but you know, when I think about the intention of the battle and why people battle, it always reminds me of why I got involved in this stuff in the first place, because, you know, it's really the battle against yourself. We are reflections and mirrors of each other. So we're battling each other, we're testing our own skills for the purpose of seeing, you know, where we're at, right? I think that's one of the main things I look towards, or I have looked towards, that have defined what I do. You know, Frost Flow, I've been known as someone who battles quite a bit, you know, whether it's on and off the floor, you know, whether it's philosophically, or, you know, to get a point across, or to represent my mentality and to share it, you know, kicking down some doors and walls or whatever, or to represent a style, you know, school of thought.